Yes, yes, it's Uncle T Boxing. And I'm here with the, you know what, I'm going to let you introduce yourself.
Introduce myself.
Introduce yourself. For those that don't know you, what's your name, your weight, everything? Tell me.
My name is Derek Delbel Saze, aka the Punch and Preacher, middleweight boxer, apparently 10-0 right now, got my boxing 3 winner. Yeah, that's about me, really.
Middleweight, yeah?
Yeah, middleweight, tasty weight. We've got a lot to talk about.
There's a couple of middleweights fighting today.
Yeah, I know, there's a few.
For the English title, you know about Linus Adolfia?
Yeah, I know.
He's fighting for that.
Yeah,
what do you think about him?
I don't really like to make comments on any individual boxers. Let's just say English titles are not what I want. So let's put it like that. I'm not really on calling out people or mentioning their names, but I'm all about want to collect all the belts. I should have been fighting on Saturday. The show got cancelled. Originally it was meant to be for the military title. It was made mandatory for that. But the holder, you had the belt, Nathan Heaney, wanted to pursue other options, and everyone else who was eligible for the belt, unfortunately didn't want to take the fight, so that fell through. I was going to be doing a normal 6-rounder, and then the whole show got pulled due to business reasons. So yeah, it's been a bit of a frustrating end to the year, but end of the day, I can't complain. We keep moving, keep training, and looking forward to a big 2020. So yeah.
So how did you feel winning the Ultimate Boxer?
I know, it was an amazing feeling, man. Yeah. It's like, I can't say I was surprised, I was shocked. Like, obviously, me and my coach, my trainer, the East Team Boxing Academy, we know what we put in. And coming into that tournament, I know a lot of people would have had me as an underdog in comparison to the less experience than the other guys, but I was very confident in my ability and what I can do. So we were very ready, we trained extremely hard for the tournament. So yeah, it's been great. It's made it a little bit harder to make certain fights since then, because apparently to certain people I'm a risk now, so my manager has struggled to get certain products. I don't really get anyone calling me out, funnily enough. I wouldn't mind a call out. I don't really call people out, but no one's called me out yet, so if anyone does, well, they're welcome to.
Did you watch a fight in Finnish Cash against
yes, I did.
Yeah,
Jack Cullen,
how did you think about that fight?
It was a very good fight, a very, very good fight. I think Jack Cullen did really well. Felix Cash did well. I think Felix Cash is a very good boxer. I think that was the first time he's probably faced a stiff challenge. I think he's sort of kind of been, I wouldn't say he's been fighting nobodies, but he's had a bit of an easier route there, do you know what I mean? But it was a good fight. It made me very excited to be in an exciting division, but it also seems to be a division where, I don't know, maybe a lot of the big fights are not getting made. Even at the highest level, like your Golovkin or Alvarez is jumping up to light heavyweight. You can't even that super middleweight, you can't get the fights made. So it's a bit of a funny weight class to be in right now, man. We're kind of in a funny time in boxing, and no one really wants to fight anyone. So, like, there's boxers I know who have watched interviews and they've said, oh, you know, I'll fight anyone and stuff. I don't want to name names, but clearly they've turned down fights with, you know, certain boxers. But yeah, it's funny, it's so much more of a business now. Everyone said they want to fight everyone, but I don't really believe everyone wants to fight everyone. So yeah, that's what it is.
Do you know about Denzel Bentley?
Yeah, I know about him. Yeah, we're good friends. I'm good friends with Denzel Bentley. We sparred a few times. We said some good sparring rounds. I know somebody, I think, tweeted. Someone must have tweeted us and said what fights they would like to see. And I think somebody tweeted me and Denzel. So who knows? That might be a fight for the future. Do you know what I mean? For the right belts and the like I said, it's nothing personal. I'm good friends with Denzel. But at the end of the day, if there's a particular belt that's on the line, I'm only interested in belts. I'm not bothered with you. It is, so if the right belt's on the line and it makes sense, then that's what it is.
Liam Williams?
Yeah, Liam Williams, he's a little bit sorry for me. He's currently avoided right now, do you know what I mean? But I'm not too sure if he's staying at middle or if he's going down to like middle. But he's a good boxer, obviously boxing out of the Ingles. I think he's at that stage of his career.
He
needs a big fight.
Why are you preaching? He's asking me,
not the white preacher. Just about Liam Williams.
This is my coach. This is my coach, Brandon Brown. We call him the sensei. This is the mad genius behind everything that's happened at DC Box Academy, just for Juice Come True. But yeah, he's asking me about Liam Williams. But I think he's at that stage now where he needs to get a big fight. fight. I think a lot of people are avoiding him. By the end of the day, I just don't know who to believe in boxing no more. He says that he doesn't want to fight him. He says he doesn't want to fight him. So who do we believe? AJ said he wants to fight Deontay Wilder. Deontay Wilder said it's them. So I feel like in boxing now, everyone's pointing the finger. So we don't know who's telling the truth and who's not. People come out and say, I want all the big fights. This guy doesn't want to fight me. But who do we believe, Uncle T? Like, who do we believe? Do you get what I mean? I don't know who to believe.
I'm not going to leave you now when you said AJ and them. Who do you think is going to win that fight, AJ or Ruiz?
I asked my coach. I want AJ to win. I just hope he's in the right mental state. I kind of feel sorry for AJ, man. There's so much pressure on him, you know. Like, I feel like he's got the sport of boxing to such a great level, and obviously he's like one of the pioneers. He's the golden era, and I feel like that pressure is just—it's getting to him, you know. So I really do sympathise with him, and I hope that his head's in the right place and does the business coming. He's a fellow Nigel boy as well, so I'm rooting for AJ, but I know it's gonna be a tough fight because. Ruiz is gonna have more time to prepare. Like, you know, Ruiz took the fight. I should know this last.
I would say if Ruiz had a 15 rounds fight.
Yeah.
I mean, 15 week camp.
Yeah, which
I think because he fought someone 6-7.
Yeah.
Rest for like a week and go into a camp again. So.
But then even that though, like being a boxer myself, you know how you feel a week after a fight. Like your whole mentality changes. Like
he went in the fight. He went in the fight. He already asked for it.
Yeah. True.
He went in the fight. Messaged him.
True.
He knew he was ready.
I just hope they've made the necessary adjustments, but I think it's not even a question of ability. I think if AJ's head's in the right place and his confidence is back, then there's no doubt in my mind he can beat Ruiz. But I just hope that, you know, how he lost the first fight doesn't play into his head.
Echo.
Man like Echo.
Listen,
English
who wins
world champion
next week? Ruiz.
I know it's the question none of us want to answer, isn't it? It's the question no one wants to answer, isn't it?
What's that? What question is that?
AJ Ruiz.
Yeah, I like him as well.
AJ will do it.
AJ will do it.
He's learned. He's learned from the mistake he made last time. If there wasn't, it's just as simple.
Yeah, I think it's more mental than a bit.
It's more mental.
You have to see one of us go.
Okay. Thank you. So what could we expect? When did you start boxing anyway?
So I started as an amateur when I was 15. I had my first amateur fight when I was 19. I turned pro about 2 years ago, so I had 10 fights in 2 years. I haven't done too bad. So I'm looking forward to a big 2020, man. There should be some things in the pipeline with some big fights. So that's the plan, really. So I'd love to add him in this area to before the end of this year. To push on from there, man. Just want to keep learning, want to keep progressing.
You're a preacher, right?
Yeah, I'm also, that's why they call me the preacher. I'm also a youth pastor. So yeah, man, all good. But at the end of the day, like, without my faith, I wouldn't be here. So it's a very important foundation.
What part of Nigeria are you from?
So I'm from Benin City.
Okay, alright.
Oye,
okay, give it back.
People normally can tell because obviously anyone is from Benin.
Yeah.
Osa means God in Benin.
Yeah.
So if you see someone's name, you can always say, you know they're from Benin. Yeah. So yeah.
Alright. When's the last time you went to Edo?
Oh, it's been a while. I've been about 5 or 6 times, but it's been since 2013.
Yeah.
I know it's been a while. Going to Nigeria now is different, eh? You need different type of money to go there in comparison to when we used to go there 10 years ago. So. But yeah, I need to get out there again, man, hopefully soon for Christmas or summertime.
As you've been in, can you speak it?
I don't, you know what, I don't, like, my elder oldest two siblings, they can, because they were born in Nigeria. But my parents thought that if they spoke Benin to me at home, it would confuse us at school. So they made sure we spoke English at home. So obviously,
do you understand it?
A little bit. If you start going into full sentences, my brain can't. It just muddles it up. But yeah, I wish I could have learned the language more. But obviously, it's harder to learn the language if you're not immersed in it.
So, bro, thanks for your time. And Uncle T signing out.
Uncle T Boxing signing out.